Hello friends, welcome again. In this video, we are going to study the formation of incidence matrix. And this topic is in continuation with the previous topic, graph theory. In the previous topic, we have studied how to make a directed graph of any given circuit and how to assign different nodes and how to make a directed graph by considering different branches. So let's say this is a network graph and consisting of 4 nodes and 5 branches called as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and the direction of current is assigned in all the 5 branches. Now, to make a tree out of this graph, we have various combination. So I am going to write all the different combination. So first one is by considering 1, 4, 2 and 3. So we can make like this. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. As we know that tree should be consist of all the 4 nodes, and there should not be any loop using these nodes. The second one will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. The third one might be like this. Then fourth one, and the fifth one, and this is the sixth one. Seventh one, and the last one may be like this. So in all these combinations, what we can see is all the graphs are consist of all the nodes. That means the branches are touching all the nodes, and none of the graph having any loop. That's why these are called tree. So whenever we write incidence matrix, we will be considering the main graph, and to write cut set or tie set matrix, we will be considering the tree branches. So let us write the incidence matrix for this particular given graph. So we are going to consider the main graph to write incidence matrix. In this, we can see that at node 1 there are 2 branches connected, branch 1 and branch 5, which is going away from node 1. At node 4, 3 branches are connected, 3, 4 and 5. All 3, 4 and 5 branches are incoming to the node 4. Similarly, at node 3, one branch is incoming, other branch is outgoing. So based on the direction of this, we can write an incidence matrix. So to write incidence matrix, we have to take a row and column. So number of rows is number of nodes. So this is first row. Means first node, second node, third node and fourth node. So we have total 4 nodes here. So there will be total 4 row in the matrix. Similarly, the total number of branches are 5. So we can write branches here. Branch number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we will see on every node how many branches are connected and whether it is incoming or outgoing. For example, if we see the node number 1, to write the first row of matrix, we will be seeing the node number 1. So first row equivalent to first node. So at first node, we can see that branch 1 is outgoing and branch 5 is outgoing. So outgoing branch we will consider as plus 1. So we can write plus 1 at branch number 1 and branch number 5. Plus 1 at branch number 1 and plus 1 at branch number 5. Rest of the branches are not connected to the node 1. So 2, 3, 4 branches are not connected to node 1, so it will become 0. Similarly, if you come to node 2, branch number 1 is incoming. So branch number 1 is incoming, so it should be minus 1. Branch number 2 is outgoing, should be plus 1. Then branch number 4 is also outgoing, so branch number 4 is plus 1. Other branches are not connected, so it will become 0. Now come to the node 3. Node 3, only 2 branches are connected and branch 2 is incoming, branch 3 is outgoing. So branch 2 incoming means it is minus 1, branch 3 is outgoing, plus 1. Other branches are not connected to node 3. Now node 4, we have 3, 4, 5 as incoming. So all 3, 4, 5 will be minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1. Branch number 2 and 1 is not connected, so it will become 0. So this matrix is called as incidence matrix. And the property of this incidence matrix is, if you add any column, you will get 0. So if I add the first column, plus 1, minus 1, so it is 0. Similarly, column 2 is plus 1 and minus 1, so it is 0. Column 3, plus 1, minus 1, 0. Column 4, 0. Column 5, 0. So this is the property of incidence matrix. The addition of elements of any column in the matrix will be 0. Now, in these 4 nodes, any node can be considered as reference node. For example, one can consider this as a reference node, then all other 3 will be non-reference node. So if you have total number of nodes equal to 4, there will be 1 reference node and 3 non-reference node. So in that case, if I consider the node 4 as reference node, the incidence matrix will be reduced. So to reduce that, we have to just delete the row 4, because row 4 is considered as reference node, so we will delete the elements of matrix from the row 4. And remaining matrix we can write as 1, 2, 3, these are nodes. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are branches. Plus 1, 0, 0, 0, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, 0, minus 1, plus 1, 0, 0. And the sum of the column is not going to be 0 in this case, because we have not considered all the nodes. So this type of matrix is called reduced incidence matrix. So in next video, we will be seeing how to write cut set and tie set matrix. Thank you.